football.
Professional football, that is. Welcome to the show. Brock Page here. And may you twist your bookie's nuts into a unique pretzel. Houston's at Seattle for a 4 o'clock Eastern start. The Seahawks open up this football game as the 6-point favorites and the total at 42.5. Since the betting opened up, however, a lot of Houston bettors and a lot of over bettors as well. Right now, Seattle's laying 5.5 with the total moving all the way up to 46.5. Wow. Currently, the Hawks are 250 to win it outright. And at the moment, 56% of the public money's on Houston to get the job done. Now, if you're betting sides in this one and you're favoring the Texans, just keep in mind that the Seattle team has covered their last 3 consecutive games and are 2-1 covering when laying the points. In addition to going 1-0 covering in games at the current total, Seattle's garnered themselves some marquee covers over the likes of the LA Rams, as well as a double-digit lay over the Colts. Seattle's going up against a Houston team who's without their best player and have a quarterback who's getting too much credit for throwing jump balls. Yeah, I said it. They also lost 2 of their previous 3 before last week's game against Cleveland. And they've only covered just 1 of 2 games against teams over 500. All that in mind, the case for Seattle bettors can certainly be made. Now, before I pick a winner, here are some more numbers for you. Houston's given up just 15 points per contest in their last 2, throwing out that KC game. Meanwhile, on the other side, Seattle games are 2-0 to the unders in their last 2 themselves. They're giving up just 8 points per game in those 2 unders. All told, the case for the under whizzes can certainly be made, and I'm on board with you. Let's go against the public action all the way around. All told, I'm buying the hook and taking Seattle -5, Seattle money line under 46.5. Next game, Dallas, Washington, 4:30 kickoff, nation's capital. We got ourselves a good old-fashioned flip of the lines in this one. Washington opened as the 1.5-point favorites in the total at 50.5. Since the betting opened up, however, most of that early money came pouring in on the Cowboys to take care of business. Right now, Dallas is -2, with the total moving downward to 49.5. Currently, the Cowboys are $1.30 to win it, and at the moment, just 37% of the betting public has action on Washington, so look for them to be catching about 3 points by kickoff. Both teams have been relatively lackluster when it comes to the number. That said, I certainly have some serious concerns for Washington bettors. The Skins against the spread are just 2-4 overall, 1-2 at FedEx Field, and 2-3 as the dog. Even worse, this Washington ball club has lost 2 of their last 3 outright and has failed to cover in their last 3 straight. Meanwhile, a little bit different story on the other side as Dallas successfully covered 2 of their last 4. Dallas against the spread has also gone 2-1 when traveling in 2-1 as the official road favorite. All told, if you're betting sides, all roads lead to the public action. Meanwhile, if you're betting totals, keep in mind that both teams' games are 3-0 to the overs in their last 3 respectively. Washington's given up an egregious 29 points of scoring per game. Not too shabby on the offensive side of the ball, though. Washington's averaging just about 23 points of scoring per game themselves. Meanwhile, very similar story on the other side as Dallas is scoring a whopping 34 points a game in those 3 overs. Oddly enough, they went 1-2 straight up in those games where they were scoring all those points. Must be due to the fact that they gave up 35 points in each of those 2 games they lost in that stretch. All that said, this has all the makings of being a shootout. I'm going to have to disagree with the public money when it comes to the scoring here. But when it comes to the number, I think the public's got it right and had every right to flip those lines. All told, I got to ride with the Cowboys -2, Cowboys outright over 49.5. Next game, Sunday night prime time. I'm ready for this one. Can't wait. Hopefully I can bring my man Stevie from Half Moon's Picks some luck here. Pittsburgh traveling to Ford Field to take on the Detroit Lions. 8:30 kickoff in the D. Pittsburgh open 3, now 3.5. Total open 44.5, now 45. Currently, the Steelers are $1.45 to win this one outright. And at the moment, just 43% of the action's on Detroit. Not looking too good there, Stevie. The public money's backing the Steelers in this one. The bright side is that you might end up catching another point by kickoff, and at that juncture, you can certainly buy it up and get those Lions catching 5 at home, just paying a little juice. Not a bad proposition there. Not going to lie, though, folks, when it comes to the trends, this will certainly be a tough one to pick for me. We got Detroit at 3-3 against the spread overall. Meanwhile, Pittsburgh holding the slight advantage at 4-3 against the points. Pittsburgh holds the slight advantage in the location game as well. They're just 2-2 on the road, but the Lions have covered just 1 of 3 games at Ford Field. Bright side for Detroit bettors, though. This Lions team has covered 60% of their games when catching points. Meanwhile, the Steelers have covered just 3 of 6 as the favorite. Detroit's also gone 3-1 covering in games at the current posted total. The Steelers on the other side have covered just 1 of 3 as the official road favorite. Looks like the Lions might be good catching a few points here. But before I go ahead and select an official winner, let's break down the scoring. Detroit games are 3-1 to the overs in their last 4. They scored nearly 30 points per game in those 3 overs on average. They also gave up a rotund 36 points per game in those overs as well. Meanwhile, somewhat similar story on the other side. Pittsburgh games went 1-1 to the overs in their last 2. They scored 29 points in that over against Cincy just a week ago. All told, the case for over bettors can certainly be made, and I'm in full agreement with you. All told, I'm buying the hook and taking Detroit +4, Pittsburgh outright, over 45 in a shootout. Close one, too. All right, folks, next and final game for the show. This should definitely be a good one. Both teams slumping, both teams underachieving at the moment, both teams extremely talented. I'm talking about Monday Night Football, Arrowhead Stadium, Denver at Kansas City. The Chiefs opened up laying 7 with the total at 44.5. Since the betting opened up, for some reason unbeknownst to me, we've seen some early action come in on the Broncos to get the job done. Currently, KC's laying 6.5 against the spread, with the total moving downward to 43.5. And at the moment, KC's laying 330 betting units to win this divisional rivalry outright for some cold, hard, sweet, and succulent moneyline cash. If you've been betting Denver to cover this year, I'm sorry for the loss. The loss of your bankroll. These guys against the spread covered just 2 of 6 overall and 0-2 covering on the road. More recently, the Broncos lost and failed to cover 3 of their last 4. Meanwhile, drastically different story for the Kansas City side. Although they've struggled in the last few weeks, this Kansas City ball club against the spread is still an impressive 5-2 overall, 2-1 at Arrowhead Stadium, and 4-2 laying the points. They're also 2-1 covering as the official home favorite, and 2-1 covering against teams allowing less than 21 a game. I think if you're betting KC here, you should be in good shape. But before I select the winner, let's break down the scoring. Denver games just have not seen a lot of scoring in them. They haven't. Broncos games are 0-3 to the overs in their last 3. In those dismal matchups, the Broncos averaged 8 points of scoring on offense in those unders. Yikes. Defense wasn't all that bad, though. In those 3 unders, the Broncos D gave up just 18 points a game on average. Meanwhile, on the other side, Kansas City games went 1-1 to the unders in their last 2 themselves. The Chiefs were held to just 13 points of scoring in that under game. All that in mind, I think the betting public's got this one right. I'm not so sure we'll see fireworks here in Kansas City. All told, however, I got to make a pick, and I really think the Chiefs should get back on track with a W here. I'm going to buy the hook in this spot right here on Monday Night Football and take KC -6, KC money line, and the under 43.5. All right, folks, that is going to do it for me. But before I get out of here, I have to remind you that I am not a sports betting expert, nor do I implore you to take any of my picks. A wise man once said, good ain't free, and free ain't good. If for some reason you decide to use the free information on this program, you're utilizing it at your own discretion. Most importantly, if you're betting any of these games, do it safe, do it responsibly, and most important, have fun. For Brock Page Productions, excuse me, I'm Brock Page, and have yourself a positive day.